Hello world, my name is Hardik, in case you are new here. And in this video, I'll show you how to create this scribbly messy line art portrait illustration, whatever you wanna name it. And you don't need pen tool or pencil tool or drawing tablet for this. I'll take A4 size artboard with pixel units. I chose pixels because it's relatively easy to work in this project. If you want to print this, then set PPI to 300, but I'm not going to print, so I'll keep this default 72. Using lower PPI while working with raster images makes software run smoothly. Color mode to RGB. I'm going to use this image with good lighting captured by this guy. If you want to practice with the same image, then link is in the description below. I'll duplicate this photo to keep original for referencing. Convert the photo into vector using image trace feature. I'll have to modify image trace parameters. Set mode to color. We need only two colors, so I'll set colors count to 3. First and second color as midtones and shadows. Third highlight color, which we don't need, will be deleted later on. These advanced options are not necessary to match with mine. It's up to the image how smooth or sharp is. Greater the noise value, smoother the edges. Uncheck this ignore white button. When you are happy with the result, click the expand button from here. Ungroup everything. To delete all the white shapes at once, select any single white shape. Here is a button to select similar objects. Choose fill color from its pop-up menu. You can do the same by going to select menu, same, fill color, and delete. If image contains tiny details, then get rid of it. Toggle outline view by pressing Ctrl or Command Y. Select with lasso tool and delete them. By using select with same fill color button, select all the dark gray objects and turn them into black. And all the midtone objects to this gray. These are just regular rectangle shapes filled with the particular color. Now separate all the black shapes and white shapes into another layer, which makes the workflow easy. To move them to another layer, you don't need to cut and paste. Instead, select them all and just drag this colored point onto the black layer. Do the same with gray shapes. Create a new layer for background. I will use this off-white for background. It looks good than pure white. Now I'm going to use scribble effect. If you never used that, then I recommend to take ellipse or rectangle as a guinea pig. Go to effect, stylize, scribble. Here are various presets to use. Before going ahead, remember that this is non-destructive effect. So Illustrator has to store the information and render in real time. If your CPU is not that strong, then please use this guinea pig idea till the end. And keep this preview button off while working on actual photo. Train your fingers to press Ctrl S after each major step. I will start with the snarl. set angle value for line direction. I'm using scroll wheel for value change. Path overlap is for spreading lines outside or inside. Adding variation will make it even better. Here is stroke width, which is self-explanatory. Hold Ctrl or Command key for decimal increment. This is curviness and variation for curviness. Spacing value makes it denser or light. Be careful with lower values. Lower value means more path, which means CPU heavy. So don't scroll in this box. At last, this is spacing variation. As this is non-destructive, effect will adjust itself if you modify the shape. You can expand the object to convert it into vector path. For some body parts where angle of lines varies, split the shape with knife tool. First, I will deal with all the black objects. After each input, wait for Illustrator to render the effect. Render time depends on system strength, so turning off preview button helps for low-end PC. Use Eyedropper tool to quickly pick the same effect from other shapes. If your Eyedropper tool is not working as expected, then watch this Everything About Eyedropper video, linked in the description below. Change the angle and path overlapping value of Scribble according to the body part. Black part is done. Lock the layer to avoid conflicts. Because this is mid-tone color, do not make it too dense. Main photo is done, let's add cherry on top. Select all the major covering areas, which are shirt, beard and hair, and duplicate it into another layer above background. You can see this is what we copied to another layer. Lock the main black and gray layers, we don't want any problem with them. Select the new duplicated shirt, and modify its scribble settings to create line overshoots. I made two copies of beard to add another scribble angle variant. Add extra shapes if you want to. These are the scribbles behind the main photo. So that's all it takes to create this artwork. If you have any questions, then please ask me in the comments below. If you learned something, then please like the video and subscribe the channel with bell icon to keep notified for all the upcoming videos. There are lots of videos I have already posted, so please check them out. Thank you for watching.